We're going to go through some cache management enhancements that will happen in the 2024 Release 3 update. First one's a simple one, but one that should save some headache and some keystrokes here. What they've done inside cache management, when going into a bank reconciliation, whether you're continuing an existing one or you're going in for the first time, when you go into that bank rec, you'll no longer have to switch your filters over to see all your unmatched transactions. They've changed the default. So in the past, it was just set on showing unmatched for checks. And so a lot of people miss the deposit area of it. So for example, I'm in the preview of the new release. If I select my bank account, and we'll just say I'm doing a bank rec here when this opens up for 11:30, and I'll click continue, you'll notice here it's subtle, but you know it's definitely in something that users have asked for. You'll notice here on the left, the state now is going to say unmatched, and it's going to say, so by default now, it's going to show just your transactions that have not been matched, not have been cleared yet, but all transactions, so any deposits and or checks as well. And just to kind of verify that over in the existing release, R2, I can do the same thing here for cache management, and I go to bank, and you'll notice as of today, before this enhancement comes out, is you'll notice here on the left, it doesn't default to all transactions. So it's a minor change, but it will save a lot of headaches and confusion going forward. So be aware of that and check that out. And there's nothing additional you need to do to make that filter, you know, be defaulting to all. So you should be good to go on that. So that's the first step here in that process. Next, we're going to talk a little bit about bank transactions and importing them. So there is a new functionality called Bank Transaction Assistant File, where it's a centralized import that you can do if you're importing your bank transactions manually. This only works for banks, does not work for credit cards, but you can turn this on. And in order to do that, what you're going to need to do is you're going to need to go into, let me get back to the home screen here. You're going to need to go into top level and go in your subscriptions. So under company, admin, subscriptions, and go down to your, and you're going to scroll all the way down into the bottom, your Sage Cloud Services. And when you're in your Sage Cloud Services, you're going to be able to enable it if you haven't already. This is also where you can do your bank feeds. So you can enable it overall if you haven't. But if you have enabled it, maybe you're using bank feeds, you can come into configure here. And you're going to see a new button here called Enable Bank Transaction Assistant File Import. It's a long, long title. But if you check that off, that's going to make that function available to you to use. So once you check that off, and you just have to make sure you click save, and it will enable that functionality. And before you begin, you'll need to make sure that you go and update the security controls so you're able, or your users are able to have access to that. So, you know, as far as security goes, company, top level, admin, and, you know, go into the role that you want to assign, your banking role or whatnot. I'm going to use my administrator role. And I'm going to go over to subscriptions, and you're going to notice if you select in the cache management area for your permissions, there's a line here that's bank transactions for API and import. And you're going to want to make sure you have add, delete, you know, view list security for whatever user or whatever user role you want to perform that bank import. Okay. So once that's turned on, you're ready to go. And I'm going to go ahead and click save here. And just like anything else with bank accounts, we're traditionally going to be at top level. So if I go over at top level to my cache management area, under all, you're going to see a new menu item called Bank Transaction Import Files. And you can see here, I can hit plus to do a new file, or I can click on the name here to see existing ones that I've already done, what date, how many transactions, and so forth, okay? At that point, if you're already in this screen, you can just click add And what the system's going to do is it's going to ask you which bank account do you want to do the import for. And we'll say we're doing it for our operating account. It will show you the last date you did that, how many transactions, what the amount was. So, you know, just in case you did a duplicate. It will also give you a warning in the next steps if you are importing transactions that are familiar, have the same date, same amount. It'll say, hey, are you sure you already imported this? In this case, we're going to click continue. What I like about this is it provides a nice wizard for you. And with the R3 version coming out, the enhancements are now you're going to have the ability to import more types of files. In the past, in the prior version, you could only do a CSV file or a QIF file. Now you'll notice here we have all the Excel files you can do and OFX. There's a lot of different file versions that, you know, something that your bank might, when you click export from your bank, it might come out that way. So you're going to have a lot of different options. And also you're going to notice you have an option for what you want or need your import layout to look like. So they have a 3-column version and a 4-column version. And the difference there is a matter of whether you're going to, and let me pull my sample up here. I have a 4-column sample. In this scenario, when I grab it from my bank, it separates by column money in and money out. Deposits, credits, it separates them by column. So I don't need to put negative and positive. So I can use a 4-column. If you use a 3-column, it will know whether it's a money in or money out by a negative or not. So you would just have one column there. So again, if you're exporting it from your bank and they send it out to you by default as same column for the amount, just a minus or positive, you can use the 3-column import. What's really nice is if you're unsure, click on this how to set up your file right here. It takes you in there. It gives you examples. It tells you kind of what you need to do here. And you could just, and you can even download an example template and use that template to start off. Okay. So that's there for you. And again, it's just a wizard here. I have a sample file. I'm just going to import in a few transactions here. Let me just update this date a little bit. Let's go 8-1 here. And let's go 7-5 and just make it a little bit more unique. 7-7 here. So let's save that. Okay. So I'm going to pick my file, and that's a 4-column. I'm actually saving it as a CSV. It could be an Excel file as well. I'm going to select my file, and wherever you keep your file, you're going to browse to it. Mine's right here. And then you can pick how you want your dates to process. So I'm going to use mine's in month, day, year, which is typical. I do like this comment. You can put it in here. So you can use it for a reference later on, especially if you're importing a lot of files. And then basically at this point, you're going to click upload file. And it will go through and it's going to do some verification for you. We'll let that process. And it found one error, a future date. So I have a future date in here. And I'm going to go ahead and I'm just going to change that date. Let's put it back to July. I'm doing it on my other screen. We'll put it back to July. I think it's not letting me do my future there. So let's start the upload again. So it'll verify it for you. 4-column CSV. Select my file, grab it, upload it. Oh, and I gotta select my month, day, year. And we'll just call it test file. Upload. We'll try that again. And once it's done processing, it's gonna verify that you're using the right import. So what it's saying here is, all right, so I'm going to pick a line here, and what is this? Is this a money in or money out? So it's going to kind of make sure and check that you got the columns correct. So you're going to go find that one, one transaction in your system for $76.50, and you can see here that is money in, right? So let me get that out of the way. So that is money into the account, return lumber, verify, and now it says, okay, these are good. but it does recognize that I have a transaction for the same amount from before. So this is nice too. It'll make sure that you haven't imported the file twice. I'm just doing some demo sample data here. So we're going to go ahead and let that import through. So I'm going to click import transaction. And this is going to process. And so it's saying, okay, I'm going to do this behind the scenes. You can go on and continue while I do this. I'll give you a status and let you know when it's good to go in your system. So if I click okay, it's going to bring me back to the main screen. And you'll notice this one's status is still in process. Okay, so we're going to wait for that. And you can see my prior ones are already completed. Those will be in my bank transaction file. These ones will not. So we'll go ahead and wait a few minutes for these, and then we'll take a look at them. Okay, so now with a little time-lapse videography here, transactions are completed on the one we did. So if we go over now to top-level cash management bank transactions, you should now see those transactions that we imported in, which is right here, in the system. And now they can be used as, you know, same as a bank fee transaction that can come in. They can be used to be matched and create transactions from and all the other functionalities in cash management. So that's available there for you. The final enhancement we're going to talk about today in cash management is a big one. And now give the system the ability to restrict users by entity for bank recs. So, you know, in the past, you would set up the users, and let's say you have six entities, but only want a particular user to get into a couple entities, and they need to do bank reconciliations, which need to be at top level. So they have the ability to go in and do bank reconciliations. So for example, right now, if I go into this demo database here, let me close some of these screens. I don't have it enabled yet. So right now, let's make myself, for example, right now I can see all the entities in the system. So for example, if I was a user that should just be in a few entities, I'm going to go into here in my user setup, and I'm going to have the ability in the user security to secure by entity. So I'm going to give it access to top level because I need to for bank recs, but I should only be in the residential company. Okay, so I'm going to click save here. Now it's going to kick me out once I update my password. Let me remember my password here. And once I make these changes, it's going to kick me out. I'll log back in. We'll go ahead and log back in. And when I log in, you'll notice I don't see all the entities on my list. So that's going to keep me into working into only the entities that I have security to, which in this case is just residential, Timberline Residential. But if the user, and this is as of today, if I need to do bank recs, I'm giving myself security, you know, we've given me security to do a bank rec. And I can go into cash management and I can go into bank reconciliations. But if you'll notice, I can see every bank account from every entity still. So there was kind of a gap there in that security setup where, you know, I could still go in and do a bank rec for a different entity, even though I didn't have security, for example, GC operating. You know, I can go in and do a GC operating bank rec. Okay. Oh, I turned it on. Okay. So what you could do in the past, but not what you can do is with this new release that's coming out, you can go into the top level under configuration and you're going to have a new button in here. And if you scroll down, I apologize, I was in the wrong company. That's why it didn't work. So if I go into cash management configuration, there's going to be a new button here in the configuration under banking called enable user entity restrictions for bank account. So you'll need to enable that. You'll check that off. And that little button there is now going to prevent someone like myself, and I'm going to have to give me security again. So let's do this one more time. I did it in the wrong company before. So let's go into users. And let's go into mine. And let's go edit here. User entity. And I'm just going to give myself access to residential, but enable top access. And give myself security to that. Like we did before, it'll sign me out. I'll come into here. And I'll log back in. And now that I have that button enabled, if I go into cash management and I go into bank reconciliation, you'll notice on my list now, I don't see any banks because there's no bank for that entity that I set up. So I can't get into the other company's bank accounts because I only see residential. So I can't get in and do bank rec for another entity's bank account. So that functionality is definitely huge, especially if you have entity level security set up and you have users doing bank reconciliations for specific banks related to only certain entities. You're going to want to enable that. And again, that's going to be under cash management, setup configuration, enable user entity restriction for bank accounts, and then you can proceed to set up your security as you have already in the past, or it might already be set up, but in your user setups, you can define each user which entities they can see. Now, I happen to be an admin automatic also, so I can take that out, and now I can see all the entities. So those are the three big cash management enhancements coming out for R3 for 2024 Sage Intacct R3.